We shall now take a look at algorithm where we are going to calculate the area of a circle. The area of a circle is given by the formula pi into radius. So the first thing is, whenever you are trying to solve a problem using an algorithmic approach, you need to identify what are the variables and constants. The first variable is going to be the radius, which I give it the name r. The next variable is going to be the area, because the value of area depends on the radius and not pi, because pi is a constant and it is 3.142. So the first step what I'll do is, I declare these two variables, radius is 0, area is 0, and this constant pi as 3.142. So the first step in your algorithm after the start is going to look something like this, alright? So in this step, what is going to happen here is, you're going to have radius as 0, area as 0, and pi as 3.142. Now, in order to calculate the area, it is required that the user provide you with the value of the radius. So step number 2, what I am going to do here is, I am going to ask the user to enter the value of the radius. So I am going to read the radius from the keyboard. So once I read the radius, now I am able to calculate the area. So in step number 3, what I am going to do here is, I am going to calculate area as pi into radius. And finally, once I calculate the area, all that I am required to do is, I am required to print the area. So what I am going to do here is, I am going to say write area of a circle is, in double quotes, area, and then I am going to stop. A few things I need to tell you. In order to differentiate variables like r and area from a constant, it is a good practice, whether you are writing a program or whether you are drawing a flowchart or you are writing an algorithm, that as a convention, represent constants with uppercase names. So just by looking at it, you are quickly able to tell that this particular fellow happens to be a constant. Just a good convention and a good practice, not compulsory, it's your choice. That's why I've shown it with a blue double box indicating it's a constant. So r represents a memory location whose initial value is 0, as shown here. Area represents another memory location whose value is 0. And pi represents a third memory location where I have given it a constant value, 3.142. So just to emphasize and re-clarify again, all the variables or constants need to be given certain memory locations. Since we do not deal with numbers of memory location, we don't talk about memory location 1000, memory location 2000, we refer to them by names. Why names are given? Just as I and you are given names for identification, in order to identify that memory location, memory locations are given the name like r, area, and pi. So let's do a dry run of this. So in the first step, if you see, r is 0, area is 0, and pi is 3.142. Step number 2, I am reading the value of radius. So in step number 2, what is happening is, the user, let's say from the keyboard, enters the radius as 5. Area has not changed, the value of pi has also remained the same. In step number 3, I am calculating area as pi into r. So this is 5 into 5 is 25, 25 into 3.142 is going to be around 78 something. So here what happens is, r doesn't change, but area changes to 78.55, pi remains as it is. In the fourth step, whatever is in this double quotes is going to come as it is on the screen, and the area value is going to be displayed as 78.55, or on the output screen you are going to see 78.55. Again, just to re-emphasize, the sequence is very important. If you change the steps, you are going to get completely wrong results. And most importantly, to know whether your algorithm or your logic is right, prepare a table with the variables listed in the columns vertically. For each of these steps, do keep track of how the variables are changing. For example, I had done some mistake. Okay, I had calculated the area here. Okay, and I had forgotten to read. Alright, so what would have printed here? You would have got an output of 0 being printed as area of a circle. Now obviously 0 is not a correct answer. So then you will immediately know there is something wrong in your logic. So please follow some basic good practices. This is way of testing your logic is known as dry run. So even when you write your own C program, do not just try to type it the minute you are given a program. First write it on paper, Do a dry run or see if the logic looks fine. Because 80% should be spent on paper, just 5 or 10% of the time should be spent actually typing and running it. That's considered to be a good practice of writing programs, not sitting in front of the machine and typing and getting lost and confused.